how many martyrs we put in the ground in the 60s and 70s. Let's not forget how many of our leaders had to leave the country or are in prison. You strip out a whole generation of leadership. You ran them out the country, you put them in prison, you put them in cemeteries. And then you unleash this blitzkrieg. And we don't have the ability to defend ourselves. You can tell the story of white leadership in America and never mention the FBI one time. You can't tell the story of black leadership, not one, without having to deal with the full weight of the criminal justice system weaponizing its black descent.
I'm tired of living every day under the threat of death. I have no martyr complex. I want to live as long as anybody in this building tonight.
Dr. King, people forget, was not this beloved figure that everybody wants to put on a pedestal. He was considered one of the most dangerous people in America by the head of the Federal Bureau of Investigations. Don't tell me that Dr. King has no relevance to the young brothers in the street. They deal with little bitty cops. He was dealing with the top cop.
We were brought here against our will. We were not brought here to be made citizens. We were not brought here to enjoy the constitutional gifts that they speak so beautifully about.
Malcolm's whole entourage was infiltrated with police. He may have had as many police in his entourage as he had regular folk in his entourage, undercover, so afraid of black dissent.
FBI Director J. Edgar Hoover today asserted that the Black Panthers represent the greatest internal threat to the nation.
J. Edgar Hoover said, these Panthers represent the greatest threat to American democracy at the time.
The Panthers never were that big. I mean, no one in their right mind could ever believe that the Black Panthers were going to bring down the greatest military force in the history of the world. The whole movement was criminalized and destroyed systematically by the government.
I think people haven't thought about what it means to lose a Fred Hampton, who somehow was able to pull together blacks and whites and Puerto Ricans and Native Americans to fight for justice at 21.
We're going to say it's not just not the hell locked up, not everybody locked up.
He had to go.
The head of the Black Panthers in Illinois was killed today by police in Chicago.
Illinois Panther Chairman Fred Hampton and another Panther leader from Peoria, Illinois were killed.
This is where our chairman had his brains blown out and he laying in bed sleeping at 4:30 in the morning.
They literally went and shot his whole house up with his pregnant wife next to him in the bed. So afraid of a leader that can unite people.
We know the history of folks who've done this kind of standing up to these systems, and we know how the system has murdered them, assassinated them, exiled them, excluded them, or found ways to discredit them.
Assad Shakur was one of the great leaders of the Black Liberation Army.